You might have seen Leslie, one of our producers, doing investigations on our show, but this time the subject matter is something much more personal to her. With a family history of cancer, Leslie wonders if she'll face the same fate and if genetic testing might provide her some answers.
My dad had this infectious smile that lighted up the room, and when I was growing up, I was absolutely daddy's little girl. My dad was having some stomach pain, so he went in for routine gallbladder surgery, and then I get the call. My mom told me that they found cancer, and they think it was originating from his pancreas. He fought the pancreatic cancer for over a year. He was in tremendous pain throughout the course of his cancer, and in his final days, he was incapacitated. He would love to hear me play the piano, and I remember playing his favorite songs for him. He loved to hear me play the piano. I really wanted him to be there to see the woman that I've grown to be today. My dad was only 57. Less than a year after my dad died, his father died of the same disease. So one day I was at my doctor's office and he started going through my family history. I thought that I had put pancreatic cancer behind me after my dad and grandfather died. And here it came flooding back, and now I'm worrying about my own life.
You have two successive generations of pancreatic cancer. Your aunt, who is on your father's side, had breast cancer. When you look at that group of people, it does suggest the possibility that there is a genetic component here. Based upon that information, I'm going to make a recommendation to you.
Okay.
I think you should be tested for the genes that code for pancreatic cancer. And most of those genes actually are also breast cancer genes. So at the same time we're focusing on pancreatic cancer, you will learn about some of the genes that cause breast cancer if you're positive for those. Typically what we do is we draw blood on you and it's sent out to an outside lab. And based upon those results, we make a decision what we can do to reduce your risk if you're positive. Now the first thing I tell every patient, and I really want you to think about this, is do you want to be tested?
I think that I would like to get this genetic testing to get some answers.
Leslie and her doctor, Dr. Mitchell Spurr, join us now. And Leslie, after your visit with Dr. Spurr, what happened?
I actually had the laboratory hold my results for months. I told them not to do the testing. They would call me every week. Do you want to go through with it? Do you want to go through with it? And I didn't know if I wanted to know the truth. I didn't know how much it would impact my life if perhaps, you know, I did test positive for those genes.
What did you end up deciding in the long run?
I told them to do it, and I got my results, and I am negative for all the genes.
I always try to say genetics is two parts. Genetics is the science of genetics, and it's the science of being a human being. Because you really have to sit with your patient. It's not just saying, okay, here's your results. You really have to treat human beings and really sit with them as long as it takes.
So Dr. Funk, let's talk about who needs to consider genetic testing.
Right, so you think about your family tree, mom and dad's side, first, second, and third degree generation relatives, and what you're looking for in the cancer family history is young, multiple, or rare, meaning cancers that happen prior to age 50, multiple, a whole lot of cancer going on, any organ, just lots of it, three or more cancers, or rare. The big rare ones are pancreatic, like Leslie's, ovarian, and stomach. So if you have any of these factors, seek out genetic counseling and they'll let you know if you should do some testing.
But I do fear, and there are a lot of companies out there who are offering genetic testing, and they'll tell you, oh, you do this test, and then you know you're in the clear. And I do worry that people feel like we're at this place where we know with certainty. And you're the one who raised the point before that was really great, which is just, it doesn't mean you're not gonna get pancreatic cancer. It doesn't mean it's an imperfect science still. I don't believe doctors should force patients to make one decision or the other. If you know the risks and you know the data and you sit down with your doctor and you decide it's not right for you, I think that we have to, as doctors, respect that.